everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die. So it was in the life of Christ. From the beginning, he had known the seasons of his Father's purpose. Soon, the season of birth and growth would end, and the righteous branch, once held by a wooden manger, would die within the cruel embrace of a tree. A season for planting. And the child grew up like a tender branch before the Lord. A strong young man, Jesus was respected by those around him. He amazed them with a wisdom beyond their understanding, and God's pleasure was upon him.
Light that shone of Bethlehem.
A season for building. At that time, a man named John came preaching in the desert. Known as the baptizer, he prepared the way for the ministry of Jesus. Get ready, for the kingdom of God is near. Repent and clear away your obstacles. Straighten out your living and start building new lives. It was John of whom the prophet Isaiah spoke these words. A voice of one calling in the desert, build up, prepare a smooth and straight way for the Lord.
Awake, rejoice in the day.
reason for gathering together. After John was put in prison, Jesus began preaching. "The time has come," he said. "The kingdom of God is near. Repent and believe the good news." He began calling others to follow him: Peter, his brother Andrew, James, and John were among the first. Leaving their families and livelihoods, they followed Jesus throughout Galilee. His ministry grew as he taught in the synagogues and preached, and word of his reputation as a healer spread. Soon, large crowds from the region were gathered to him and began to follow wherever he went. A season for loving and hating. As word of Jesus grew among the people, his clashes with the religious leaders escalated. Knowing that it was only a matter of time before they found a way to halt his ministry, he took his disciples to Jerusalem. Large crowds lined the roads, spreading their coats and tree branches before him. Some people ran ahead, while others followed behind, shouting, "Save us! Blessed are you, our King, and the kingdom you bring." As they entered the gates, the whole city began to ask, "Who is the cause of all of this excitement?" The crowds answered, "Jesus, the prophet." But some of the religious leaders said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell the crowds to be quiet." Jesus answered, "It is useless to deny them. If they are silent, the rocks themselves will cry out." And the leaders said to each other, "This is getting us nowhere. Look, the whole world seems to be following him." a season for weeping. The chief priests and the elders met with the high priest and plotted to arrest Jesus and kill him. But not until after the Passover feast, they said, or there might be a riot among the people. Jesus knew that the time had come for him to leave the world and go to the Father. After celebrating Passover with his disciples, he took them to an olive garden named Gethsemane. In the darkness, he knelt down and prayed. Father, the time has come. If there is no other way for your purpose to be accomplished, then I will do what you ask of me. With great anguish over what was to happen, he prayed alone in the darkness. There was no comfort for his sorrow.
The events of the first Holy Week, kind of like this, started off parade, procession, hallelujah, hosanna, excitement. But what we know is that as the story unfolds in Holy Week, the praises become derision, and celebration becomes confusion and anger. We invite you to come, continue to worship as we remember Christ's story, Maundy Thursday, Good Friday. On Good Friday, our choir will sing two more pieces from the cantata they've been singing today. So Thursday, Friday, 7 o'clock, and then next Sunday, 7, 9, or 11. If you would, please rise for the benediction. We always end with these words. I'll just say it to you today. But the words are, God loves you and so do I. Okay? Remember how much God loves you. And the story of God's love, that's what we see unfolding in the gospel in Holy Week. So go in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.